Dear friends, continuing with our Guru Purnima series, today we have with us the Prashna specialist, sir.
Namaste.
Ramdas Rao ji. Namaste, sir.
Namaste.
हमारे सभी व्यूअर्स भी आपको हैप्पी गुरु पूर्णिमा बोल रहे हैं. सर, सो आज हम क्या करने वाले हैं? What are we doing today?
I thought of discussing about the importance of Guru Purnima, why it is called Guru Purnima, and because it is Guru means here, the Guru Purnima is normally we call it as Vyasa Purnima. So, who is this Vyasa? A general outlook. This I want to give.
Okay. Yes.
Namaste. So, as we are celebrating the Guru Purnima, so we should know, because this Guru Purnima is very, very auspicious period for everybody in this universe, normally, I can say. Because the Guru, who is the Guru? Guru may be the teacher. The teacher may be for the students in the class, in the high schools, in the colleges, and even for those who are the astrology students. So for everybody, there is a Guru. So this Guru Purnima has been celebrated in India, especially in India, in almost all places. And this is not only for the Hindus, for the Buddhists also. Because Lord Buddha started his first preaching on this day.
Oh.
Yes. So that is why this is very auspicious day. And what I'm telling is about the Vyasa. Vyasa is nothing but, his name is Vedavyas. So, regarding this Vedavyas, normally before telling about him, I want to tell about what is the meaning of the Guru. So, in that, Guru means Gu. Gu means our difficulties or our ignorances. So, or the darkness. Guru, we can say, is the darkness or ignorances. And the Ru is the removal. So, Guru means the who can remove the darkness or the ignorance of all of us. So, that is why we surrender to Guru on this day. And this Guru Purnima is celebrated because this is the birthday of Guru Vedavyas. And Guru Vedavyasji, he is the Guru. Actually, he is born during the Dwapara Yuga, 3rd millennium BC. He was born. And he is, so actually he divided the Vedas into 4 parts. So this was the day, not only for his birthday, the day he divided the Vedas into 4 parts. That is why this is very, very auspicious for all of us. Because this is, because one is his birthday, second one is the day he has divided the Vedas into four parts.
Yes.
Now, Maharshi Vedavyas is also known as Krishna Dvaipayana, because his character comes in Mahabharata actually. It is in Dwapara Yuga. So, he was born, we want to tell about his birth. He was born in an island near river Yamuna. So, his mother's name is Satyavati. Satyavati, and along with the fisherman. Fisherman, that is he is the adopted daughter. The adopted daughter for the Satyavati. Satyavati and the Parashara. Maharshi Parashara, which we are always discussing about the Parashara astrology. So, he is the father, and their son is Guru Vedavyas. Yeah, Guru Vedavyas. And the Parashara Maharshi is the son of the Brahmarshi Vasishtha. So, Maharshi Parashara, actually he wants a son who is like his father. Father, that means Maharshi Vasishtha. He is a Brahmarshi. So he prays to Lord Vishnu, and Lord Vishnu gives a boon to him that he will have a son who is equal to his father. That means that is the Maharshi Vasishtha. So that is why the great Maharshi Vedavyas is also known as is a Brahmarshi Vedavyas. Yes, he is the equal power like Brahmarshi Vasishtha Maharshi. So that means Maharshi Vedavyas is considered as in our place, because Vasishtha is long before Maharshi Vedavyas. So Dwapara Yuga, and then came our the Kali Yuga. So in these two yugas, because the Maharshi Vedavyas was not only born in that time in the Dwapara Yuga, he wrote Mahabharata. So that means yes, because he knows everything. He is like the Amsha of Lord Vishnu. Yeah. So that is why we consider him, instead of praying to Lord Vishnu directly, we consider to pray Guru Vedavyas. So we get the blessings of the Guru as well as the Lord Vishnu. So that is why this auspicious ceremony of Vyasa Purnima or the Guru Purnima. So regarding the Maharshi Vedavyas, in his previous life, he was the Rishi Apantaratamas. His name was Maharshi. It's not Maharshi, Rishi Apantaratamas. So he was born to Lord Vishnu. His previous life. And when Lord Vishnu uttered the syllable Bhu, you know the Gayatri, Om Bhu, Om Bhu, Om So. So when the Lord Vishnu uttered the syllable Bhu, so at that time, the Maharshi, this Apantaratamas was born. So that means the Maharshi Apantaratamas, he was having the knowledge of complete Vedas at that time itself. Because Lord Vishnu has blessed him from that time. So in the next life, because he has, at that time itself, he was having the knowledge of the Vedas, Upanishads, and all the, you know, spiritual scripts of the ancient times. So, as per the Lord Vishnu's orders, he was again reborn. Because after the prayers to Maharshi Parashara, so again he was reborn. Because all his memory as Maharshi Apantaratamas, he's been completely carried over to the present life. And that is why we have to consider him as the most auspicious, most holy guru. This is the most important thing what we should learn. Because he was also a Maharshi in his previous life.
And he had carried all the knowledge to this
place. Yes, all this knowledge from that period. Because Lord Vishnu wanted him. Lord Vishnu has told Parashara Maharshi that I wanted him to be born again. Because in this yuga, there is nobody to spread the Vedic scriptures, the Vedas and Upanishads, there is nobody there. And I wanted him to be born in this yuga or the age.
Yes.
As your son. So that is why he is born again as Maharshi Vyas. And Krishna Dvaipayana, why his name is Krishna? Krishna means when he was born, he was black. So that is why, so the name is, actually it is Krishna Dvaipayana. But then it has turned into Veda Vyas, because the person who has got conquered all the Vedic knowledge, it's called Veda Vyas. So, why before the birth of the Lord, the Guru Vedavyas, the thing is that his father, it is the Maharshi Parashara, he made a big tapas or penance to Lord Shiva. So Lord Shiva has
you know, immediately he appeared in front of the Maharishi Parashara, and he gave the boon or the var, you can say in Hindi, you can say var, that his son would be a Brahmarshi equivalent to Maharshi, his grandfather, that is Maharshi Vasishtha. So when Lord Shiva has given the boon, so it has to happen. So as we know that Maharshi Vedavyas again reborn, and he learned all that. Even at the after the birth, immediately he started chanting the Vedas. So much power he has got. He has got all the previous life karmas, all this he knew. So that is why. Sorry. So the thing is that now in this Kali Yuga, we wanted the blessings of the Guru. So if we worship comparing to all other Gurus, we have to give the first preference to Guru Vedavyas. This is the most important thing, but this is my personal opinion. So that is why there is a Veda mantra is there. There is a mantra is there. Om Vyam Veda Vyasaya Namaha. This is the most auspicious mantra to get the blessings of the Guru Veda Vyas. So anyhow, this he got the, even though he knew the Vedic knowledge. So in his, after taking his birth, he took the Vedic, higher Vedic knowledge from the four Kumaras, that is Sanakadi Kumaras, this we call it as the four Kumaras, and Lord Brahma, and plus the Narada Maharshi. All these three, they were joined together. Here they have given all the Vedic knowledge, Upanishads and all these things, knowledge to the Maharshi Vedavyas. So that means Maharshi Vedavyas is not a person at all. He is the God, because he has got all the knowledges. So if we surrender to him, we get all the knowledges, and he removes all kind of our difficulties in our life, yes. spiritual life. Because finally, as per the Nadi astrology, we have seen that the final attainment is to reach moksha. So Guru will take us to reach, means he will give the steps how to reach the moksha, because it is, the moksha is not a simple word. It is very, very difficult, and we cannot expect that I wanted to get moksha. Moksha will not come like that. Only by these good deeds, either the man or the woman, by the good deeds, slowly, not the first janma or the life. Maybe he has to take, or she has to take a lot of janmas, which is not known to anybody. And finally, when nothing is there, because you can say that in the Bhagavata Mahapuran, which is very auspicious Purana actually, in that I have read about, see, when the person is about to die, or when he is died with the Atma, the Manas, that is the Chandra or the moon, it is also carried over. So this moon, that means the mind, whatever we have done in this present birth has been carried over to the next birth, until the Atma has taken a particular, because of the karmas, what the present life, the parents, who are the parents, who are the brothers, sisters, or the wife and the friends, so, and the gurus. So whatever the person in the present life we meet, so the God will decide who is having the highest karmas for him. So the next life, the God will decide, okay, this is your parents, this is the father, this is the mother. So the mother will take him as in her womb as her son. So until the child is born to the earth, the child knows each and everything, what has happened in the previous life. But as soon as it comes to the earth, it forgets everything. So the new karma will start. this is you know what I wrote, you know, read in Bhagavata Mahapurana. So the moon is the most important thing. That is why Purnami, Guru Purnami. So Purnami means the moon in the full power. Yeah. So in this condition, but I don't want to, you know, tell more about these things because we all know. Because most of the people, they know about the Guru Purnima. So that means with this, I end that everybody has to, you know, worship this Guru Purnima or celebrate this Guru Purnima every year with the full. Because this year it was not that much, you know, successful because of this, you know, the coronavirus and all those things. Let us hope that in the next year, so we will celebrate this in a very, you know, auspicious manner. Because the thing is that in the last year also, on this Guru Purnima, if I will tell you one instance, I never expected, just 1 week before of the Guru Purnima last year, one of the Nadi astrologer in Karnataka, it's called K. Ramamurthy, he just called me, sir, please come to on the Guru Purnima day. We are inviting you. I said, yeah, why? No. We are inviting you. You have to come. I don't know what has happened. I said, okay, I will come because it is Bangalore. So very near to from my native place. I reached in the on the day of the Guru Purnima in the morning. So after the my pujas and everything finished, I reached the place where he has told. Then when I reached, he says that we are going to honor you as a guru on this Guru Purnima. there were about 10 gurus he called, who are, you know, very excellent in the Parashari astrology, some are in Jaimini astrology, like this, and some are in Prashna. So he said, even though he is an expert in Nadi astrology, he said he wanted to honor me. So it's all the guru's wish, the God's wish. So in this year, because of this corona, this one, the only in the home only we are doing the, you know, prayers to the gurus. That is what I can say.
So yeah. There is a continuation of this. We are also honoring you, sir. Yes. All of us in Vedic Vision, yes. And yes. My own viewers on YouTube and everything.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you. So, viewers, please do this mantra. Sir has told us, Om Vyam Veda Vyasa and Namaha. Every day, this will definitely improve your guru wherever it is there in the chat. Plus, it is a direct connection to Lord Vishnu. As sir has explained here. So we say, we take your leave now. Please do subscribe to the channel and let us know in the comment box, how did you find this session? Thank you everybody for watching our videos. Thank you, sir.